Now I come to Mr. Ganesh Karki, who is the president of IPAN. The first question, Ganesh ji, to you is, it's quite noteworthy that IPP's contribution in generation has been the key for development of the electricity sector in this country. Now, where do you foresee the scope of the private sector beyond generation in the coming days? How is the private sector preparing to be involved in power trade, both in domestic as well as cross-border market? This is the first question. And second, as an experienced domestic private sector investor, what specific areas of reforms you want to suggest to the government to create an enabling environment for attracting further private sector investments, both domestic as well as from abroad? Thank you.
Thank you, Dinesh sir, Honorable Minister, and all the distinguished panelists, and very esteemed guests from all over the world. So thank you again. And then Nepal is waiting for investment, and so definitely we have seen the presentation that we required a huge fund in Nepal to the renewable energy. So beyond the generation, definitely we need the transmission line, because without transmission line it's not possible to transmit the quality energy to the even we cannot export to energy. So the before coming in the transmission line, I just want to add some points that, because we have seen in the presentation that Nepal aspiration is ambitious, that we Nepal planning to, and Nepal aiming to 28,000 megawatt by 2035. So we need huge investment for that. So and 13,500 megawatt is for the domestic consumption, and 15,000 megawatt to the export. So it could be more. So we need $46.5 billion to complete to this target. So that's why the private sector are also seeking the meaningful partnership with all the stakeholder, and this is the one of the most significant areas that could invest, because without generation we cannot transmit the energy. So I also like to request all of you that there is one area that could be invest, and because we already showcases so many projects in here also that we can discuss, and IPAN is here to support and facilitate you always, because IPAN, we have more than 500 companies are member in IPAN. So IPAN is is negotiating with the government, and then we work for the policy with the government, and we try to be a bridge with the government and the IPPs. So second thing is definitely the transmission line, one of the area that we could invest. And so, and because with the support of private sector to investing in this sector, hopefully, because we have sometime we have some kind of problem that it is not being complete within a time. The transmission line is being a major issues of here. And third could be one of the major area that we have discussing, one of the agenda that is electricity trade between Nepal and India. And both countries are advocating the open access channel. So even Nepal is now facilitating the private sector to invest in the areas to for the private energy trading, and we seek your meaningful partnership with the companies and from the all over the world, and we always welcome to you. And then second thing, that it could be a rapidly progress if we got the support from the both countries. We could be rapidly progress to export the electricity to India and even in Bangladesh, and export and import to continuously talking with the both stakeholder, and it will be a pivotal role of the private sector that can be a success. So hopefully we have seen in the presentation that 10,000 megawatt in 10 years. So with the support of if the private sector, it could be a double, I think. So this is the major area that we could work, and hopefully there is a new technology are here in market. So the solar is coming up, and the hydrogen is next to, we can discuss that. So the second question, I wanted to highlight some points to, we have a honorable minister here. And so major thing, I just wanted to put some points that we have to be policy stability and clarity, because to invest, it should be clear. And streamlined regulatory process, that even so many times we are requesting to the government, it should be a fast track service or one door service. And the investment incentive and guarantees, because the foreigner are coming here to invest, so they need some kind of guarantees by policy or regulatory. And definitely it is very hard to say, but it was in last budget, infrastructure development support, it could be so many kind of road or transmission line. So the another point is the risk management mechanism, hedging, fund, insurance, and so many issues are there. And so definitely easy repatriation process, so everyone wants this. And the electricity bill is in the parliament, it should be approved as soon as possible. So because of that, so many, even the trading business, even we could not do now immediately. So the another issue, that land acquisition within a conservation area is being a problem nowadays, because especially in Kanchenjunga, there is some issues that should be resolved as soon as possible. Even just recently, so many law has reformed, so we have to thank the government that it's been more easier than before. So what we are facing. So thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you, Ganeshji.